and at the same time, it doesn't stain my skin. So let's start with a bare face and a clean eyebrows. In my case, I have a very thin eyebrows and a scattered one too. So we need to draw an outline first before we start. So what we have here is an eyebrow palette, and in this case, I am using a medium brown color, and I am using a wet brush before I dip it in the eyebrow powder so that the powder will stick much better to the brush and to the brows. Then let's start outlining both our brows. If you have a very thin eyebrows like mine, start imagining what you want your eyebrows to look like after you filled in or after you completely filled in your brows. And when you start outlining, try to fill in or try to draw as lightly as possible so that you can still see those very thin eyebrow hairs. In here, I am using an eyebrow puller to pull those straight eyebrow hairs. Even if it's not so noticeable here in this video, but I still have those straight eyebrow hairs outside the line, so that's the purpose of this puller. So after outlining your eyebrows, you can now start pulling those eyebrow hairs, those stubborn eyebrow hairs outside the line, and it may look so easy, but honestly, it hurts, but that's what we call tiis ganda. So go for it, pull those hairs until it's done. After pulling out those hairs, there are still baby hairs that's left, so that's why we need to use a razor or blade for this step. I am using this kind of blade because I find it easier to manipulate. It can be curved when I shave those baby hairs out from my eyebrows. Then, let's do the same to the other side of the brows. Shave out those baby hairs from your eyebrows outside the outline we have made earlier. When you're done, wipe the outline we have made earlier so that we can clearly see how it looks like after it is being shaved. So after we have shaved, or after the shaving is done, it is now time to outline our eyebrows again. This time, it is for the purpose of shaping and filling in our eyebrows according to the shape of our liking. In this case, I want my eyebrows to look like semi-Korean but with a youthful look. So we are trying to draw a straight line but at the same time with a small arch at the end. When filling in your brows, try to fill in as lightly as possible because later on we can just build up the color. And when you are filling in your eyebrows lightly, it is easier to build up the color thereafter. So when you have already started shaping and filling in your brows, try to brush those harsh edges, especially the base of your brows, to neutralize the color that is being applied and to lighten the base of the brows because we wanted the base of the brows to be lighter compared to the tail of the brows. So in this case, we wanted the tail of our brows to look much darker. That's why we add an eyebrow color to the tail part and do the same to the other side of our eyebrows. Personally, I find it advantageous when using a wet brush and an eyebrow powder because it is easier to neutralize, it is easier to brush, and it is easier to distribute the color. And at the same time, when the color is beyond the line, we can just easily wipe it with a baby wipes or with a facial tissue. So let us finalize the shape of our brows, especially the end part of our brows, and later on brush those areas where darker color is applied and neutralize the darker color through our spoolie. Then it's time to wipe the excess color that is applied beyond the outline we have made earlier through our brushing with a spoolie. So this is what I said, it is easier to remove because we can just use a wet wipes and just enhance the tail or the other part of the eyebrows that needs more color. So, as I said earlier, we are trying to achieve a semi-Korean look. So, we were trying to make our eyebrows as straight as possible but with an arch at the end. So, remember to also fill in the ends or the tail of the eyebrows much darker compared to the base of the eyebrows. So again, don't forget to brush those harsh edges to neutralize the color and so that it doesn't look too heavy in the eye. And what you did to the other part must also be done to the other side of your brows. And don't worry if both your eyebrows doesn't look too identical, because as they say, our eyebrows are just like sisters, not twins. So it's okay if it doesn't look too similar or too identical with each other. And now, when you are already satisfied with the shape of your brows, it is now time to polish the look. It is now time to polish the shape of your brows. Just brush, don't forget to brush the harsh edges. Don't worry with the excess color of your brows outside the line, because again, you can use wet wipes for this part. I am not tired to brush, to use the spoolie to brush those harsh edges just to polish the look, to polish the shape of our eyebrows. And if you have an oily skin, maybe using an eyebrow powder is not ideal because it can be erased easily after you sweat. But if you have a skin like me that I don't sweat much, I like it. I find it better because it stays longer on my eyebrows. So, if we are already satisfied with the shape of our eyebrows, it is now time to set our eyebrows using an eyebrow gel. At this stage, other people use an eyebrow mascara to set their hairs, to set their eyebrow hairs. But for me, I prefer to use an eyebrow gel because it sets my eyebrow hairs just the way I wanted it. And at the same time, I don't have to risk having to stain my skin with the eyebrow mascara because using an eyebrow gel just sets my hair the way I wanted it, and at the same time it doesn't stain my skin. Just do the exact same process in applying an eyebrow gel to the other side of your eyebrows. So I guess that's pretty much everything that I wanted to share with you guys, and I think we have already achieved the shape that we wanted and the color that we wanted with our eyebrows to look like. So thank you guys for watching, and hope you like this video. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and ring the bell button so that you will be notified for our next videos. Thank you.